We already looked at a stoichiometric chart. This one's a new stoichiometric chart, and we use this anytime we're doing stoichiometry and molarity is involved. So, just like before, we're gonna say that entities means atoms, molecules, or particles. And just like before, we're gonna be given information. So we're gonna have given information. That given information will help us find unknown information. So in this case, because we're dealing with molarity, that's gonna introduce a new unknown, volume. And here when we say volume, volume could be milliliters, it could be liters, it could even be microliters. The base, of course, will be liters. Now, how do we go from volume of given to moles of given? To do that, all you have to remember is liters times molarity will give us these moles. Okay? And remember, we say that liters times molarity represents a complete set. So instead of giving us the moles of a compound, they could say we have 25 milliliters of a certain molarity of a compound. That's the same thing as saying I have that many moles of that same compound. From this, remember, we can go from moles of given to moles of unknown by doing a mole-to-mole comparison, just like in the last stoichiometric chart. And if you know moles of unknown, you can find entities of unknown by using Avogadro's number. And you can go to grams of unknown if you know the molecular mass of the compound. And then how do you go from moles of unknown to volume of unknown? Well, we just say simply moles times molarity would give me liters. So again, we're going to say you use this chart when given a chemical reaction or chemical equation with a known quantity in either milliliters or liters or molarity of a compound or element, and asked to find the unknown quantity of another compound or element.